Pop quiz. You're a pro designer and you just finished designing this mockup for your client, but they want a real website, not a pretty Figma file. So what do? I'm gonna show you how to build it in Editor X. Let's go. Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. This is the first video in a short series where we're gonna be building a creative agency website using only Editor X from beginning to end. Editor X is a powerful web creation platform that empowers pro designers and agencies to build beautiful, modern, responsive, and dynamic websites without needing to be or hire a professional developer. It's very easy to use, but I'm here to make the process even easier and fun. So I found this design on Frontend Mentors, and it comes complete with the starter files and a creative brief. So we're gonna treat this like a real client project and build this entire thing out. Let's go. All right, to grab our design, I'm gonna go to frontendmentor.io, and under the challenges, I'm actually going to scroll down and find this site, the creative agency single page site. This is the one that I want to build, and it does happen to be a premium challenge, which requires you to be a premium Frontend Mentor member, but there are a bunch of free challenges as well. So if you wanna try out some free challenges, you could totally do that without signing up. So this is our creative brief down here. Your challenge is to build out this single page website and get it looking as close to the design as possible. You can use any tools that you like to complete the challenge. Great, so we're gonna be using Editor X. And the user should be able to view the optimal layout for the site depending on the device's screen size. So we want it to be responsive. There are some hover states and interactive elements as well. And we need to navigate the slider using the mouse, trackpad, or keyboard. All right, so I've already started this challenge and downloaded the assets. So I'm gonna head over to Figma, and here in Figma, is the creative assets that I was able to download. Comes with all of the different screen sizes for the designs, from desktop to tablet to mobile, and a design system as well, which we can use to set up our design system in Editor X. So just taking a quick look here, I can see it's a very nice site, relatively straightforward layout. Some interesting kind of elements here where we have elements overlapping images, cool typography here, call to action, and I believe we also have somewhere where we need to, yes, right here, we need to navigate through different screens, and I think it shows us the different screens here. So the slide two, so this is slide one, slide two, slide three. Okay, pretty straightforward. We got the responsive version here. Great. So now that we've got that, we're gonna start transferring our design system over into Editor X. So let's do that. All right, so I'm gonna be using Editor X to build the site. So editorx.com, the platform I'm using is Editor X. The kind of website I'm gonna create, I'm gonna say business. This is just to help filter themes and stuff, but we're gonna be using a blank canvas. All right, and now we have our blank canvas that we're going to work from. First thing we're gonna do is start by building our design library based on that Figma design file, that design style guide. We're gonna be referencing that to build out this design library. So here's how we do that. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do in Editor X is to pull in these colors from our design file. Now we're gonna bring in the font, which is called Commissioner, and we can find that on Google Fonts. We'll go ahead and download that font and then upload it right into Editor X. Let's set the font sizes. Now, let's create some global buttons that we can use throughout the site. We'll design the primary button. and it's hover state. And then we'll save it as an asset within our design library. This is going to allow us to add this exact button throughout the site whenever we need it. We'll design our secondary button with its hover state as well, and then save that as an asset. Finally, we're going to create some navigation arrows. And once we've done that, we're going to save that as an asset as well. All right, now we're going to upload the images, the logo, and the graphics that came with the starter files right within the EditorX Media Manager. This way, we can find these files later once we need them. All right, now that we've got the design library all done, this is gonna help speed things up tremendously as we keep building the site. Does it make sense so far? If so, hit that like button, let me know. Okay, so we're gonna build our header. As you can see here, we got half of it white, half of it red, a logo and a nav. Let's do that. So when we start a fresh EditorX website, you're gonna see this basic structure here. We've got a header, just a set blank section and the footer. The green set highlighted sections, those are masters. And so those are global sections that will be shared across the pages so that you don't have to recreate them every time. Very smart. So what we're gonna do is just click on that apply grid and we're just gonna create 2x1. So I think that just means two sections by one, you know, by the same unit. So it looks like this. You can also change the grid layout here and you can go advanced mode and then change the units that these grids will be. So this is CSS grid. So to create responsive layouts, you click on this, you can change the column width. You can use fraction, percentage, auto pixels. You can, whatever you want to do there. Column width, we're going 1 and 1. So that's one fraction. So they're both even. Now in there, what I'm going to do is add the logo on this side. Now that I have it dragged within here, you can see it's actually within the header, which is perfect. I'm going to make this over to the left side about 250 pixels from the left. So we're going to make sure that this is docked to the left and we're going to say 250 pixels. You can just type PX and it will actually change the unit to pixels. You can manually change them like this. I'm going to vertically align it by just using these little buttons here. So now we've got that positioned where I want it. And now we need to add that navigation. So to add a menu, I'm just gonna hit add elements. I'm just gonna click on menu and search. I'm just gonna choose a basic horizontal menu. And what I'm gonna do here is drag it into the right side of this column. It will attach it, manage menu. And I'm going to add some new pages so that the pages dynamically appear in the menu. And then I'm gonna do some positioning. Now that I've added some pages here, I can go to manage menu, add new item, and then I can choose all pages to dynamically appear. And there they are. I'm going to change the layout of this navigation. Now it's time to add that button. So there we've got the basics. Now we need that red background here, and then we're gonna start positioning this, and then we're basically done with the header. So to do that, I'm actually gonna select both of these, place them in a container, and then I'm gonna stretch this container to fill the entire half of this grid. Update the colors, position these better. So I'm gonna move this button over 150 pixels from the right of the page. Now let's move this navigation menu over so we can see it. I can just drag it if I want, but I like to be precise. And then we need to update this button. And now the button more closely matches the design. The navigation menu is a little off. We need to change those colors. All right, that's looking good. And let's just make sure that the height of this header matches the design. So the height we have here is roughly 180-ish pixels. So we can do that here by clicking our grid, changing the grid layout, and adjusting the height right here. Okay, and now that we have our desktop view good, let's check our tablet. Now we're going to adjust this to make sure it matches our design. And if I look here in Figma, I can see the design slightly change here. So I'm going to make sure that that matches. Now let's move on to our mobile. It looks like we have our logo and a hamburger menu, and then the navigation kind of pops out. Let's do that. Okay, so here in the mobile view, we got a couple things that we need to address. I am going to open up our layers panel, and I'm going to hide our container, the red one, adjust our logo, and I'm going to add a hamburger icon. So if I go to our add elements and I go to menu and search, hamburger menus, I could choose from a few different styles here. And of course you can adjust them however you want. By default, this hamburger menu is not part of the header container. So I'm just going to drag it up, hold command and option so that we can attach it. And then now it should be a part of the header. Now I'll make some adjustments to the positioning and the color of the hamburger menu, just to better match the design. And so when I open that menu, I can adjust all the styles like the background color, the vertical menu. It's dynamically added based on the menu that we've added prior to. And then I've added a button in here. You can change all the colors and the positioning of this slide out menu. And I am going to make sure now that if I go back to my tablet, we don't see our hamburger icon, which is not displayed perfect. And it's not displayed on our desktop. It should only display on our mobile view. So now we are good. Let's just preview that. Now we're just testing our design on desktop view, tablet view, and mobile view. Everything looks good. I'm happy. This is perfect. Okay, now that we're done the header section and matched it to the design as closely as possible, we have to continue building the rest of the site. So in the next video, we're going to build a beautiful hero section. Make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss that video, and we'll see you in the next one.